This is new. Probably wondering why. Hold on. So yeah, Labor Day weekend, I decided I'd try to fix the Pan American's tuning slides that were stuck. I got this one loose. This one I almost got loose. Unfortunately. Oops. Yeah, that crack let go. Started a new crack. No bueno. I mean, I could probably make this play again, but tuning slide's never gonna work, so why bother when you can have this? Oh, it might not be the Cadillac of American euphoniums from the day, but this is what everybody was trying to compete with. And so they were either trying not to get their pantsuit off, making something just like it, or make something that, you know, hopefully appealed to somebody. Yes, the Conn 20i. This one's a year older than that one. High school actually had a, it was like 20 years newer than this, but had a 20i that I played for a short stint, and oh my goodness, what a great instrument this is. This is the horn sound that John Philip Sousa was writing for. Not the fuzzy tone bath compensating euphonium garbage that you guys love nowadays. Now, this is what was up. So, let's go over the refresher for the baritone rant. Yes, this is awfully similar to a European rotary baritone. Just move the valves up so that the lead pipe is shorter. It's even more conical than ever. No, this instrument is not more cylindrical than a euphonium. There is no cylindrical tubing at all, except for what literally has to be. It's not that small. Here's the bell way up here. It's quite large. Also, companies that used to make, you know, back in the day, rotary euphoniums, rotary baritones, they considered them equivalent to a euphonium in their lineup. So, I don't want to hear it. The main feature of this bad boy, other than being super old and made out of the heaviest brass I've ever handled, short action valves. Ho ho ho. These bad boys are a dream. And if you're ever looking for a horn with short action valves, look for these bottom caps. They got this design on here that's, what's made for is to use a quarter, so you can turn it with that. That's not always indicative, but if you see these, you know it at least is. Yeah, these are amazing. So I actually did some measuring, and these are, they're as good as you're gonna get compared to a rotor. 533 is the throw on this. How does that compare to other instruments? Well, the Pan American with the same 560-ish bore is 850. That's enormous. The bass trumpet, you know, and instruments in that range are all about 600. Mellophonium, 752. That's quite big. The tenor sousaphone, 797. Not bad. Yeah. So this dominates even a trumpet. How does it compare to rotors? The B-flat alto horn with its flappy paddles, those are super fast. They're about 400, so it's not that fast. However, compared to the Soviet tenor horn, that instrument has 552 of throw, thereabouts, and this is 533. So, sometimes these are faster than a rotor. And I'm going to show you one of these. They're quite unique. And importantly enough, they actually sandbag. They could have made these faster. So you've got different size ports because the tubing that goes to the valve slide, it doesn't have to close off, so it can be whatever size it has to be. And you've got these kind of elongated ports. Very nice. It's very difficult to produce these, that's why they don't make them anymore. It's not because they produce turbulence or resistance or make the horn impossible to tune. That is all poppycock. It's very easy to play quiet on this instrument. It's very easy to play loud on this instrument. It's very easy to play in tune. It's quite good. One of the annoying things with this being so old is, unlike the newer versions from like the 60s and 70s, this has a one-piece valve cap instead of two. So the stupid valve guide gets stuck on the cap a lot. It can be hard to tighten these down. But everything works on this horn. All sides work and everything. Very nice. Piece I got with it is also pretty unique. I like how it sounds. It's very indicative of the era. I don't like how it plays for me, but it'll do. This is a King M21, the small version. See, the rim is kind of semi-flat, more like a Schilke than a Bach. Width is 24.3 millimeter, they're about pretty close to 12C, but much deeper than a 12C. Not as deep as the 44E4, but close. Different cup shape. This is more of a V. Throat, back bore is about the same as 44E4. The only thing I don't like is this inner rim. It's really soft, like no bite on it. I don't play well on a mouthpiece with limited bite, but sounds appropriate. No, you don't need to jump to a 5G or 52D or whatever garbage you guys are playing on these things. It's not necessary unless you've got a huge embouchure. It's a lot of the reason why you always hear people complaining about playing music that goes up to A. Like, you should be able to play that high on the euphonium. And you should definitely be able to play that high on a baritone. What else? I talked about short action valves. Yeah, this thing's heavy as the Dickens. Made out of thick old brass. Even as tired and wore down as this is, still plenty of material here. I mean, that was the first thing I actually noticed when I got this out. Like, I was used to that Pan American, which doesn't weigh that much. So, you know, I could do this pretty easily with that horn. This is... got some heft to her. I don't think I'd want something this big as a forward bell instrument. But yeah, this is nice. Super fast valves, beautiful sound, very punchy and powerful. Yeah. Tell me those short action valves are causing problems. They're not. No, they are beautiful. I wish they still made these. Or I at least wish somebody would knock them off. I mean, it's not like Conn's doing it, so... I don't know, Wessex or somebody. I might even enjoy a compensating euphonium if they had valves like this. That'd be cool. Oh, what else? We're going along. I mean, I played some music for you. Commanding tuba-like presence in the low register. No false pedal tone, unfortunately. So, if you want to play down there, you need to find a four-valve version, and I'm not rich enough for that. You can find them. People want a lot of money for them. How much did I pay for this? I'm not telling. More than I'm going to admit. Not as much as a four-valve would have cost me, but, you know. Yeah. What else? I don't know. I hate this mouthpiece. Sounds great, but I hate playing it. It looks good too, doesn't it? I love that old tulip shape. Yeah, make America great again and bring back the front action euphonium. It's awesome. You should play a horn like this. It's way better than that fuzzy British junk you guys keep hauling out. I promise. Get on it.